Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of Warzone Wrestling's Heat. I am, of course, your host of the show, none other than the voice of Warzone Wrestling, Jason Todd, as we are here in Oklahoma City, where will be another excellent edition of Sunday Night Heat. And well, we are kicking it off with Bryce Cole taking on Marvelous Monroe. It has just been, well, recently confirmed that Atoll Anarchy, well, Killer Machines will take on Beer Money for the Warzone Wrestling Tag Team titles. And where we're going to get a little singles action preview here as Bryce Cole takes on Marvelous Monroe. And yeah, making his way down to ring, he is one half of Killer Machines, being accompanied by the Machine. He is Bryce Cole. And well, this team of Killer Machines, they will be going up against Beer Money for the Warzone Wrestling at Total Anarchy. Just, well, 7 days away now, it comes your way. Well, next Sunday, May the 7th. Well, these two, they managed to defeat Beer Money in non-title action. It was an open challenge. So now Beer Money, well, they have the preparation time now for a week. But where we're getting some singles action here, can Bryce Cole get a little bit of momentum heading closer towards Total Anarchy? Of course, well, on Warzone, it's been confirmed that we are going to see the Machine take on BG Nelson in a singles competition as well. So we get to see, well, both team members of each team in singles action building up towards Total Anarchy. Just waiting on the opponent. Your Peer Money sure loving to make Bryce Cole wait. And here they are. Well, here comes one half of Beer Money and one half of the Warzone Wrestling Tag Team Champions, being accompanied by BG Nelson. He is Marvelous Monroe. Of course, these two, well, they defeated the Authors of Pain to become the Warzone Wrestling Tag Team Champions. And well, next Sunday at Total Anarchy, they will be defending those tag team championships against Killer Machines. And what will be, well, one hell of a heated contest. Total Anarchy putting itself with some great matches so far. The matches confirmed, of course, Dean Ambrose taking on Goldberg, with Goldberg defending his Warzone Wrestling World Heavyweight title. Luke Harper getting a rematch for the European Championship against Santiago Martinez. A big grudge match, as well, Great Dragon takes on Willie Street. And of course, the Warzone Wrestling Tag Team titles on the line as Beer Money will defend against Killer Machines. And we're just getting a small preview here as Marvelous Monroe taking on Bryce Cole. As well, Warzone William gets this underway. Apparently we could be getting a new referee. Apparently, he might be in the next match, actually. But Warzone William will be officiating this matchup for now. As well, Marvelous Monroe up to the middle rope here. What has he got planned here? Well, it seems like he had something planned and just sort of taunting the fans saying, no, I'm not going for any kind of high-risk maneuvers. I'm Marvelous Monroe, damn it. Marvelous Monroe, well, you could say both these men in this competition, you know, are submission specialists. Marvelous Monroe loves to use that figure four leg lock. Well, Bryce Cole, he has submissions of his own that are just as deadly and can end a match so quickly. But right now, Marvelous Monroe in dominant control. As, oh, just what a vicious chop, but it only seems to anger Bryce Cole. That's something you don't want to do. Do not try getting a striking game with Bryce Cole, because he can knock you out in an instant, as seen by, well, his MMA record. You know, he's a master of knocking people out and making them submit. In the early days of his MMA career, he knocked so many people out, and then sort of in the latter years, he became this submission expert. And here we're seeing the gator roll into a crossface there. There we're seeing the submission expertise of Bryce Cole, or as he was known, well, Bryce the Killer Cole. And Well, I cannot wait for Tyler Anarchy, of course, coming your way next Sunday, just a week from today. Of course, well, the kickoff show will be presented by Heat. And then you've got the main big show, more matches, of course, to come your way. As close on to the back of the head of Bryce Carl there, and Marvis Moreau has had a lot of control in this match, and now it looks like he's taking the high risk. Oh, and tried for a double axe handle, but Bryce Carl, well, he seemed to reverse it, but that seemed to still make him a little bit loopy. And now we're seeing just the dirtiness of the dirtiest player in the game, Marvelous Monroe. Now is he looking to take Bryce Cole to the outside? Well, maybe for about where it seemed like he wanted to play a bit of mind games there. It seemed like he was going to run towards him to shoulder tackle him to the outside and stop dead in his tracks and just punched him instead. Oh, look at that. Bryce Cole punched Monroe so hard he went flying into the table. Of course, here Oklahoma has been, well, amazing for us here in Warzone Wrestling. What a fantastic city to be in. And well, of course, the place of birth of our performance center helper, none other than Tim Ross. Look at that, punched again, Marvis Moreau, so hard that his head smacked into the table. As I say, do not try getting a striking game with Bryce Cole. I would strongly advise against it. Oh, and look at that. Just a disrespectful slap there from Marvelous Monroe. And yeah, that just seems to, well, piss off Bryce Cole. Yeah, here in Warzone Wrestling, we don't go to the fundamentals of PG. We do not care for that. Here, we are strong style. We are hardcore. And uh-oh. Bryce Cole has him up for that. Oh, look at this. My goodness. Almost like a gory special mixed in with a dragon sleeper. But look at the strength of Monroe to power out of that submission hold. And look at this. BG Nelson distracted Warzone William. Well, there's a chair in the ring, but Marvis Monroe has not got to use it. But look at this, figure four leg lock locked in. Is Bryce Cole going to be forced to tap out, or can he escape or possibly get his hand to one of the ropes? He is very close, but he just can't stretch it. But oh, look at this. And Bryce Cole reversing the pressure of the figure four, and that will force his Marvelous Moreau to break that figure four. And uh-oh. Oh my god. What has he got planned here? Oh, sweet Christmas! Good lord, that could have, well, seriously hurt Marvelous Monroe. Is into the cover. 1-2, but just a 2 count there. Marvelous Monroe still has fight left in him, but my god! And now, Bryce Cole, I think he seems to be on another level. I think he's just got pissed off in this matchup. As you're seeing it, a blatant choke. Oh, but look at that, Marvelous Monroe. You know, he is a technical master in that ring. Managed to reverse that, and Marvelous Monroe double underhook suplex. And well, still yet to use that chair. Wasn't William has not noticed the chair. Very shocking. And well, still just a 2 count there. Bryce Cole still has plenty of gas left in a tank. And oh, look at this, the Uranagi slam into an Anaconda Vice. Is Marvelous Moreau going to be forced to tap out to this Anaconda Vice, or can he fight out of it, or possibly get his hand over to the rope? Oh, it looks like he's very close to tap it, but now look at this, kicking the back of Bryce Cole's head. There's another Uranagi slam there. And now finally Walter William notices that chair as BG Nelson, well, tried to distract Bryce Cole here, but doesn't really do much. As Marvelous Moreau is still down and out. And Bryce Cole, I think he's calling for the end here. He looks to end this. Oh, into that submission hold again. First locked into, well, what looks to be a gory special, but then combos it with almost like a slim hold or a dragon sleeper. Oh, and Marvelous Moreau is forced to tap out there, and Bryce Cole is the winner of the match via submission. And well, what a huge victory for Bryce Cohen. Well, he really doesn't care about having his arm lifted. He gets the victory here tonight. And could we be seeing, well, a similar fashion on Warzone as the Machine will take on BG Nelson, or can Beer Money get one back this Wednesday night on Warzone? We'll have to wait and find out. Well, tonight, Killer Machines have got one up as Bryce Cole with a very impressive victory. As well, coming up next, it will be Dan Littlewood version 1 taking on Great Dragon. Well, what a matchup we have here. These two, you know, well, they've been no strangers to each other in the past. We're going to see some more great action here on Sunday Night Heat. As making his way out to the ring, he is Dan Littlewood, version 1. Well, Dan Littlewood, version 1. There's a lot that could be said about him. I mean, a lot say, you know, he's a good fit for Warzone Wrestling with his, you know, past in the world of extreme wrestling. But of course, Dan Littlewood, he's, some might say, a bit of a hit and miss superstar at times. But well, if he can begin a huge victory over Great Jacket, that'll say a lot about Dan Littlewood heading towards, well, Total Anarchy. Of course, Dan Littlewood is not confirmed for the event, but Great Jacket is. But can you imagine if, well, Dan Littlewood could defeat Great Jacket? Of course, we saw Great Jacket's opponent, Willie Street, pick up a huge victory on Warzone over, well, Nick Blackwell. So he's got a lot of momentum. And of course, it was announced that Great Dragon versus Willie Street will be a Falls Count Anywhere match. And also on top of that, it will be career versus career. The loser will be forced out of Warzone Wrestling. But here he comes, and well, Great Dragon seems to have changed his attitude a lot. You know, he attacked Willie Street backstage, which would start the whole rivalry between him and Willie Street, really spurred on their match at Total Anarchy. But tonight, Great Dragon, he has to focus on Dan Littlewood, because if he takes his eyes off of, well, tonight's matchup and thinks too much about Total Anarchy, it can cost him. But Great Dragon, well, you know, he's a real rising superstar, many say, here in the world of Warzone Wrestling. But some also have said he's well signed his death warrant come Total Anarchy when he takes on Willie Street in the, well, Falls Count Anywhere career versus career matchup. I mean, Willie Street's saying that he's going to beat Great Dragon so bad that not even Japan will want Great Dragon back. Of course, some have said that backstage Great Dragon has stirred up some controversy with people and has really rubbed people the wrong way. But enough about that, and on to this match as well. Our new referee is out. Apparently, he's called Heat Boy Harold. As well, Heat Boy Harold will get this match officiated. Let's see how he does. Well, in his first ever refereeing position. But right now, Dan Littlewood, well, he's taking the fight to Great Dragon. But look at that lovely reversal from Great Dragon. I've just got to wonder, come to Lanarchy, who will we be saying goodbye to? Will it be Great Dragon, or will it be Willie Street? As well, what a Michinoku driver there by Dan Littlewood. I mean, Dan Littlewood, there's a lot that could be said about him. He is no pushover in that ring. And, you know, he's got a lot of heart. He says he will not die. You know, that heart has driven him to great lengths before us. Look at that. Oh, tried for a springboard crossbody. But Great Dragon knows all about the high risk, high flying maneuvers and was able to dodge out the way. As well, Dan Littlewood's in a lot of trouble now as Great Dragon's taking a fight to him. And oh, just a stiff stomp into that midsection there. Oh, but look at that, Dan Littlewood with a jawbreaker there. Managed to, well, fight out of that, and now he's back in control and taking Great Dragon to outside, dumping him onto that thinly padded floor. on and a swinging neckbreaker by Dan Littlewood there. On the outside again, that's very thinly padded. There are so many ways to hurt your opponent when you get on the outside of a ring. And now, well, back into the ring. Dan Littlewood has verb control of this. And oh, look at this side effect. And well, Dan Littlewood is in verb control and he could be closing in on victory. I think Greg Dragon has underestimated Dan Littlewood here and could be about to cost him the match. Oh, but look at that. I think Greg Dragon has realized a mistake. Never underestimate anyone you get in the ring with. And well, now Greg Dragon is back in control with that snapmare there. Oh, look at this. This combination, the back fist and then the clothesline. Well, could Greg Dragon be looking to follow that up with the pause and miss? No, he wants to really get on the fans' nerves here and really anger them, it seems. Greg Dragon, well, in a recent interview, he says he doesn't care about anyone but himself now. He says, screw the honor, screw the respect. There's one man that matters in Warzone Wrestling, that's himself. But he could be, well, he could be gone from Warzone Wrestling as of next week. Oh, and it looked like Greg Dragon maybe wanted to think about setting up for that poison miss, but Dan Littlewood caught him into that Russia leg sweep and then fallen hit with the big elbow drop. And now Dan Littlewood taking Greg Dragon into the corner here. What has he got planned? Which is a stiff punch in the face. And, oh, can he be thinking of it? Twist of wood and an extreme one of that. Into the cover hook of the leg. Heat Boy Harold down for the cover against the free count. And well, the winner of the match is Dan Littlewood version 1. Well, who would have thought you'd be saying that? Great track. I mean, he needs momentum going towards, well, Total Anarchy, but he's got none at the moment after this, well, loss to Dan Littlewood here. But what a victory for Dan Littlewood. Well, proving that he is not someone to be messed with and that you should not underestimate him. As well, we are on to our main event as it will be the Authors of Pain taking on the Long Island Boys in tag team action. Well, what a hard-hitting affair we have here in the ring. Two just very big teams about to go at it. As, well, it seems our production team has, messed up here and forgot to play the Authors of Pain's music. Well, we can only apologize about that, but, well, here are the Authors of Pain, accompanied by Paul Elring, the legendary manager. Well, Cayman Razor, the Authors of Pain, they are never in a good mood. Well, I think they just want to destroy the Long Island Boys here tonight. Well, it seems that the Authors of Pain, they've not got any music player, but that doesn't make them any less intimidating. Once they take those masks off, they are just two men that are mean and vicious in that ring. You take no prisoners with the offense that they exert. But they are not taking on an easy team. The team they're taking on are certainly no pushovers, unlike last week on Heat. And it seems our production team, specifically the music team, has fallen asleep on the job here as well. The Long Island Boys don't seem to have music either. Well, we can only apologize here at Warzone Wrestling for this monumental screw up in terms of production. I hear we were very strapped for time. Production team didn't get much sleep, and this is the result. As well, the Long Island Boys, though, they are out here. Well, like the Office of Pain, they are a very hard-hitting team. They are a take-no-prisoners kind of team, you know, very powerful maneuvers. And, well, I could see this being a very back-and-forth matchup and a very, well, hard-hitting matchup. Well, the fans look ready for this huge main event. The Authors of Pain, the Long Island Boys, Heat Boy Harold. Well, he gets us underway. Well, it looks like Razor's going to start off this matchup. And just look at the power there and the strength with that backbreaker. Oh, but look at that there. Johnson Styles managing to reverse into a back body drop there. Now just grabbing at the head of neck and truly trying to just wear down Razor here. But then look at this. Razor showing off his own power with his own back body drop there. And then, oh, just grabbing a nerve there of Johnson Styles. My goodness. It's really just trying to dissect the opponent, but that's Authors of Pain style for you. Just picking apart the opponent who's using powerful and hard-hitting maneuvers to really just decimate whoever they're in the ring with. Well, I can't wait for, well, Tolo Anarchy just in 1 week's time. And well, could we see the Authors of Pain or the Long Island Boys on that card? They have not been confirmed yet, but obviously more matches to be confirmed for Total Anarchy. And oh, look at this. Look at this by Justice. Oh my god, a sit-out choke bomb there onto Razor. Razor's in a hell of a lot of trouble. I think he needs to get a game into this matchup. Look at that, just big shoulder tackle by Justin Z. And just, well, looking to wear down Razor he is. But look at that, Razor managing to fight back and then just a vicious knee into the face. And then a choke bomb of his own without a setup, but that's still vicious with that choke bomb. And oh, look at this, into an abdominal stretch. Can Justin Z find a way to fight out this, or is he going to tap out? He can fight out, and it follows it with a hip toss there. Oh, but looked like Justin Z wanted to take Razor into this corner, but no, but then reverse of his own, and oh my god, look at the strength, electric chair face buster there. Now into the corner here, what is Justin Z thinking here? Oh, taking him into the ring of ropes, is he thinking a neck break? He's got him set up. And what a neck breaker there from Justin Z onto Razor. Well, I don't know what Razor's thinking there. That was his perfect opportunity to tag in a KB. He doesn't. He gets caught off guard. Uh-oh. Oh, Justin. Well, a double axe handle into the arm there. And oh, look at this. Out of nowhere. Discus clothesline. Into the cover. One. Two, no, he kicked out, and well, Heat will continue after this quick little commercial break. And don't forget, just 1 week's time, it will be Total Anarchy coming May 7th in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Make sure you do not miss out on Total Anarchy coming your way. Well, next Sunday, May 7th, it's going to be Total Anarchy, as there's your main event. Goldberg taking on Dean Ambrose with the Warzone Wrestling World Heavyweight Championship on the line. as well. We are back to the action here, and well, finally Razor was able to get out the ring during that commercial break as well. We're back here, and long arm boys call it for it, and look at that, the flapjack with the cutter. Well, we've come back to what could be the end here. Heat Boy Harold, what are you doing? And oh, look at this Paul Ellering distracting Heat Boy Harold there. But it looks like Justin Z's going to set up for the end. And a divorce court. But oh my god, that didn't seem to affect the game at all. As he was able to come back extremely quickly. As well, we can see, it looks like during the break, yeah, Razor was busted open. Oh, and the game looks like he wants to set up. And kick, well, knee into the gut, and that discus clothesline. And just as he could be knocked out into the cover, hook of the leg. One, two. Oh, and Justin Z, I don't know how, but he managed to kick out of that. Oh, and it looks like Justin Z's now been busted open after that. Just stiff punch into the head, and then another one. Now, well, into a cover here as Razor's back in the ring. You could just see the blood there. One, two, and no, Justin Z managed to kick out there. Not quite knocked out yet from those punches. Yeah, just dropping the elbow there. And Justin Z, well, he's in a lot of trouble. He needs to tag Johnson Starks back into this matchup as... Uh-oh, here we're seeing the abdominal stretch again. And is he going to be made to tap out? No, Justin Z manages to get out of that. Oh, look at this. It came there to stop whatever. Well, Justin Z had planned for momentarily... But just able to keep the offense going. And Oh, tried for the big boot. But just as he reversed, well, dodging out of the way, and then that lovely neck breaker. And then just a headbutt there. It seemed to hurt just as he just as much. And then just dropping an elbow of his own. Oh, thought of something, but no. Razor able to, well, reverse that and into the cover. One, two, no. Kicking out does Justin Z, but he looks in a lot of trouble. He needs to get Johnson Styles back into his match, but Razor looks like he wants to call for the end. It's the knee into the gut, and a discus clothesline. And now the cover, hook of the leg. One, two, and three. And well, the Office of Pain are the winners of this big tag team match, and it's nice to see that, well, the production crew have finally woken up. But let's not take away from the fact that the Office of Pain pick up a huge win here tonight. Well, they climb up the ranks of the tag team division. They could be looking well for the next team to challenge for the tag team titles. But well, the Authors of Pain pick up the win in the main event of Heat. And well, that has been it for this edition of Warzone Wrestling's Heat. I've been your host for the show, none other than Jason Todd. And I will see you all for the next episode of Heat. But also don't forget about Warzone Wrestling coming this Wednesday night, and of course Total Anarchy coming next Sunday. Do not miss any of Warzone Wrestling's action. Goodbye for now.